Bonjour et bienvenue à l'église de St. Andrew and St. Paul. Considering Matthew Shepard by Craig Hella Johnson is a very powerful and soulful musical response to the tragic death of Matthew Shepard, a University of Wyoming student murdered in Laramie, Wyoming, apparently because of his homosexuality. Perhaps the first modern passion that deals explicitly with an LGBTQ plus subject, this concert length work of three parts, Prologue, Passion and Epilogue, is Johnson's most ambitious composition to date. It is scored for a mixed chorus, vocal soloists, narrators, piano, clarinet, strings, percussion and guitar. Johnson sets a wide range of poetic texts and includes additional texts sourced from Matthew's own notebook and also words from his parents, Judy and Dennis. The work premiered in 2016 in Austin, Texas, and the A&P Choir is proud to present the Quebec premiere and the third production of the full work in Canada. Thank you for joining us in this life-changing journey as we contemplate and as we are transformed by Matthew's story.
Grace, grace, and see. sway and pass and pass and circle.
Let's talk about Matt.
Ordinary born, ordinary born, ordinary born.
Born in December in Casper, Wyoming.
Friends and evil graces, and his reign was rather small.
poet writes about himself in a notebook.
I am funny, sometimes forgetful, and messy, and lazy. I am not a lazy person, though. I am giving and understanding and formal and polite. I am sensitive, I am honest, I am sincere, and I am not a pest.
I am not a pest, I am not a pest, not a pest.
I am my own person, I am more. I want my life to be happy, and I want to be clearer about things. I want to feel good. I love Wyoming. I love Wyoming very much.
I love Wyoming. I love Wyoming. I love Wyoming so much.
I love theater. I love good friends, I love succeeding. I love pasta, I love jogging. I love walking and feeling good.
I love Europe and driving and music and helping and smiling and Charlie and Jeffrey. I love movies and eating and pausing and people and pasta and driving and walking and jogging and dancing and dancing.
Stories, wanting to remember where and who. Laramie, southeastern Wyoming, between the Snowy Range and the Laramie Range, Tuesday, October 6th, 1998.
Empty prairie, the moon bathes me, the stars bless me, the sun warms me, the wind soothes me. Somebody someday stumble upon. Will anyone remember me after I'm gone? Still, 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 I wonder. Anyone remember me after I'm gone?
Still, still, still,
I wonder.
Tuesday night, Matthew attended a meeting of the University of Wyoming's Lesbian, Gay, Bisexual, Transgender Association. Then joined others for coffee at the College Inn. Around 10:30, he went to the Fireside Bar, where he later met Aaron McKinney and Russell Henderson. Near midnight, they drove him to a remote area, tied him to a split rail fence, beat him horribly, and left him to die in the cold of night.
You shall.
yet he kept breathing. He was heavy as a broken heart. His own heart wouldn't stop beating. The cold wind wouldn't stop blowing.
Next morning, Matthew was found by a cyclist, a fellow student, who at first thought he was a scarecrow. After several days in a coma and on life support, Matthew Shepard died on Monday, October 12th at 12:53 a.m. At the funeral, which took place on Friday, October 16th, at St. Mark's Episcopal Church in Casper, Fred Phelps and the Westboro Baptist Church protested outside. Thank you.
the fires of hell burn hot and red. The only good flag is a flag that's dead.
Fires of red, 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 red,
national media began to broadcast the story. As the news spread, many people across the country gathered together in candlelight vigils, moved to silently speak for life over death, love over hate, light over darkness.
In our hands? How do we guard these fears in our hearts? How long to hold these griefs in our songs? Remembering anger, fevered with hope. Remembering exile, braided with braids. Longing past horror, longing past dread. Dreaming of healing, past all our pain.
100 veils.
Aaron McKinney and Russell Henderson were arrested shortly after the attack and charged with murder, kidnapping, and aggravated robbery. The first of two trials began on October 26, 1999. Both were convicted of the murder and sentenced to two consecutive life sentences.
To my window to
I think of all the times the world was ours for dreaming, when I think of all the times the earth seemed like our home, every heart alive with its own longing, every future we could ever hope to hold. All the times our laughter rang in summer, all the times the river sang our tune, was there already sadness in the sunlight? Some stormy story waiting to be of all the joys, the wonders we remember, all the treasures we believed we'd never, ever lose. Too many days gone by without their meaning, too many darkened hours without their peace.
Days and weeks after Matthew's death, many people came to the fence to pay homage and pray and grieve.
I can't.
touched me in unexpected ways. Some of them touched me in unexpected ways. Touch me in unexpected ways, and then Matthew's father made his statement to the court on November 5th,
end of the beating, his body was just trying to survive. You left him out there by himself, but he wasn't alone. There were his lifelong friends with him, friends that he had grown up with. Probably wondering who these friends were. First, he had the beautiful night sky with the same stars and moon that we used to look at through a telescope. Then he had the daylight and the sun to shine on him one more time. One more cool, wonderful autumn day in Wyoming. His last day alive in Wyoming. His last day alive in the state that he had always proudly called home. And through it all, he was breathing in for the last time the smell of Wyoming wind, the ever-present Wyoming wind, for the last time. He had one more friend with him, one he grew to know through his time in Sunday school and as an acolyte at St. Mark's in Casper, as well as through his visits to St. Matthew's in Laramie. I feel better knowing he wasn't alone. Thank you.
Matthew was left tied to the fence for almost 18 hours.
I know.
Sheriff's Deputy Reggie Flutie, the first to report to the scene, told Judy Shepard that as she ran to the fence, she saw a large doe lying near Matt, as if the deer had been keeping him company all through the night. The fence has been torn down.
Even in this rain, signs of you everywhere, signs in the darkness.
Signs in the fires, signs of you in the hurt streets.
Signs in the tents, the tunnels, signs of you in the tiniest beating heart. Thank you, our cry to be sung.
Even in this rain, out of the mouths of visions torn open, out of abandoned tongues, out of the mouths of children lost in the furnaces.
Out of the bloody lullabies. Out of the beaks of buried eagles, the forests wrapped in rags.
Wires of lightning, loose and writhing. Out of skies as stained as the seas. We cry our song to be sung.
Even in this rain, sit with her now, old earth. Hear her stories.
All we have already been given, all we have yet to do, on watch, keeping our hands in the wounds.
Even in this rain, how might we ever say to you, we have ceased to dream? Never forgetting.
Remembering how every breathing remembers to build the world. Thank you, our cry to be sung.
Nobody, no one turned away. Nobody, no one unworthy.
Nobody, no one ashamed.
Yes, each silence. Yes, each radiance. Yes, each shadow. Yes, each praise. Mind into heart.
Mind into heart. Each dream walks on, even in this rain.
Thank you.
What in every war, oh, we are. sings the long chorus.